Like most people of the 21st century, you are probably clueless when it comes to behaving properly at a cocktail party. Perhaps you simply don't know what pair of trousers to wear with that new cummerbund you found on the sales rack. Maybe you still don't know what pleasant anecdotes will win over the hearts of the other guests. The details are irrelevant. What matters is that you are a socially awkward partygoer.
And the embarrassment is overwhelming. With my four easy steps, you'll learn the perfect angle with which to hold your glass and how to make sure your laugh reveals how cultured and sophisticated you really are. Today, we will be following our friend Joanne through the do's and don'ts of becoming the life of a cocktail party. Let's begin!
Lesson one, making a great first impression.
People form an impression of the person you are within the first 3 minutes of meeting you, so it's crucial to make a flawless introduction.
Joanne walks into the cocktail party wearing her new navy-colored pantsuit. She makes her way through the guests to find the hostess.
Hi, thanks for the invite. Didn't have time to wax. Great party.
Note how Joanne has successfully clothed herself and has approached the hostess amiably while bearing a gift. Now, let's make this good first impression into a great first impression.
Joanne prances into the cocktail party wearing her new fire engine red dress. She shimmies her way through the guests to find the hostess.
Hi, thanks for the invite. I got this for you.
An unforgettable impression. From the moment Joanne enters the room, all eyes are on her. By prancing as opposed to merely walking into the room, Joanne is able to stand out from the crowd. She is young, fun, spirited, and totally approachable. Finally, yes, the Asian elephants of Sri Lanka may be an endangered species, but that should not stop you from providing the most rare and distinctive gift in the room.
You look great. How you been?
Gee, Joanne sure seems like a pleasant, polite, proper party guest. She also seems incredibly mind-numbing, dull, dreary, depressing, and pathetic. Let's try that impressionable opening line again.
I look hot. That guy's totally gonna do me.
That's my boyfriend.
Do you see how Joanne has now left an excellent impression? She has shifted all focus towards herself and has highlighted her strengths for the hostess to admire.
Tip, know yourself and what makes you great.
Make a 2-to-3-page list of all the things you think are great about yourself. Are you particularly flexible? Fluent in any languages? Are you good at holding your breath underwater for a long time?
Oh, yeah.
Make sure to review the list before going out and provide a brief summary of all your strengths to any guests you come across.
Lesson two, conversing with other guests.
Watch the following scene between Joanne and Miranda, another party guest. Note how Joanne has successfully mastered the art of cocktail party conversing.
I'm Joanne Ballet. That's French. I'm fluent in French. I'm also a particularly observant person. I can hoo-hoo. Wow, that's very impressive.
Tip, in the new age of technology, take advantage of your resources.
Use the internet to research the names on the party's guest list. Find out their criminal history. Any diseases in the family? This way you'll have even more material to work with when it comes time to converse. Don't forget to have follow-up questions.
So tell me, has your boyfriend ever cheated on you?
Excuse me?
Ooh, touchy subject, give me the details.
I don't think that's any of your...
Is your sex life with your boyfriend suffering? Ever had an abortion? Ooh, were you a slut in high school? Ever been tested? Oh, what's that rash along the side of your neck?
Excellent! Notice how personable Joanne is? In good cocktail party conversation, you should connect with the other guests. Be inquisitive. Be curious. Don't be afraid to pry. Remember, the more they think you care, the more they'll want to share.
Lesson 3. Drinking at a cocktail party.
One Scotch Bishop cocktail on the rocks. Two parts triple sec, hold the powdered sugar, and don't try to slip a Mickey.
Cultured and sophisticated? Yes. Joanne knows what she wants, and she knows how to speak the right lingo. She is flawless at speaking alcoholic slang, and it is quite impressive. The other guests will immediately begin to ask questions. Where did Joanne learn to become so refined? What wine tasting courses has she taken? Can I learn to order drinks the same way Joanne can? Who is Mickey? You have now established yourself as a professional social drinker. Cheers.
That's what I said. Jarlsberg is the best cheese.
Joanne is at the prime level of inebriation. Have you ever seen a friendlier girl? With the help of some alcohol, Joanne is able to express her love and compassion towards the other guests and is able to be social, gregarious, and affable. Remember, people respect honesty, so drink up!
Lesson 4. Exiting your party.
A good exit should be filled with lots of drama, surprise, and maybe even some magic. Exit with a bang to let everyone know what they will be missing once you leave. Observe.
Good exit.
Goodbye, adios, ciao, adieu, au revoir.
Better exit.
Ciao, adieu, au revoir. Accio, porgio, tenere, tenere, fish to
Partylicious exit.
Important person once said, life is a party. When in doubt, just drink more. Forget all those rules about sitting with your legs crossed, drinking your one drink, and speaking only when asked to speak. Go out there and be bold, fiery, passionate, and unstoppable. Remember, people never regret the things they do. They regret the things they don't do, like ripping their clothes off and jumping onto a helicopter. I'll drink to that.
The end.